term. She's now come a long way. Right. And through God, we can do anything.
Amen. Amen. Thank God for that. Amen.
morning in a lot of churches. And yesterday on Facebook, I read things that just, I mean, absolutely just blew me away. And I'm finding out more and more that's just more gossip. And gossip sin. Come on.
Yes.
Come on, David. I have to stand mean, I feel it now. Talk of my head and soul to my feet. He's coming. He's coming soon. Oh, my Lord, have mercy. God is good. God is good. It's so good to see David and Ashley with us this morning. All of you here this morning, glad you're here, and we've come to worship. And I believe we've already been worshiping. Yes. Let me say amen.
Yeah.
I tell you what, when it was a day Friday night and the Lord down there, huh?
Thursday night
down in town, and the praise team was singing, and they had a grand opening with the hearts, and they do stained glass. So they have they have classes there, and you can take classes and make one of those. They are really unbelievable. So I'm asking you to go by there and support them and to see them. But I wanted to tell you, during their singing, and I mean, they was anointed when they sang. You that were there, I'm telling you, they just had a, we had a time. But we had a $100 donation for the church. But the praise team had a $500 donation from a lady that was there. And she owned, she had a business. And she is not a Christian. And she gave me that check with tears in her eyes. And she said, I have never heard nothing like that in my life. She was from
South Carolina.
But I want you to pray for her. Her name's Wendy. And I ask you in your prayer to pray for her that God would just get a hold of her heart. She's ready, and she would just accept Him in her heart. So I'm asking you to do that. But what a name right through the praise team. Yes. Yes. Bake sale is Friday, July 30th. It's for where's Nancy while we're at? She's not sitting here.
Yeah, she's right there.
I'm sorry, Nancy. Forgive me for all my English today. She told me the other night, I think she was just like this. She said, you and new announcements. So I had to, I'm trying to do better, Nancy. Okay? But anyway, back sale is Friday, and it's for Vacation Bible School. We're excited about it. And July the 3rd, and she needs donations, and she needs candy and cakes and pies and whatever. And Tracy's standing there. Tracy is over at Vacation Bible School this year, and we're excited because we've not had one in a while. So be sure and see her. It's going to be at the Dollar General store at 10 o'clock Friday. So make sure you bring a donation. And so our brothers are going to come, take your tithes and offerings. Let's worship and give it this morning. Come on. Baby balls. If you've not brought them, Dave Hammond said he'll give us till July 7th. He always does this. July 13th, you must want more money. So anyway, he's giving us. So if you've got your Bible, just bring it in, and we'll get it back.
Lord, we'll be having new service next Sunday, and they need to wear clothes, they can get wet.
Just all pray together. Just
pray for our nation.
Yes. And if anybody wants to be controversial about the Supreme Court decision, answer with love. Just answer with love.
Right.
And tell them, you know, we love him. We don't agree, but we love him.
Yes,
we do. We still love him. Pray with him. Heavenly Father, we just come before you right now. We love this. Thank you, Father, for your mercy and your grace. We thank you, Father, for everything that you do to us and come before us. Father, we ask you to touch our nation today, Lord. God, bring healing upon our nation. God, let's unite our churches together, Lord, that we'll stand for the truth.
Yes.
we'll stand up and speak our mind and say what's going on for you. We ask you, Father, touch our communities, Father, bless our brothers and sisters, Lord. Each and every one of those that are sick, that you just built them up. God, you will heal them, you will deliver them, you will be with them today, Father. God, we ask you to touch the service you've been ready to have, God, and we're having, God. We just worship you in spirit and truth today. Lord, bless his home from about your sin. Bless each and every one here, Father. Give you our praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
know, I thank God because I think about that being that lunch. They made me forgot that. And what they are, we are all can be so replaced. But I just wanted to thank the church because I know everybody here was praying for you. It renewed a lot, my faith in people. You know, you hear a lot of times about people aren't there for people anymore. And there are so many people in their homes helping those kids. They have church people there. They have their Bible friends there. They have their neighbors. It just went on and on. They were there in groves. They were bringing food. They were bringing drinks. They were staying there hours at a time, helping them go through and salvage out of that home when they could salvage it. And then I know we had the church here praying, and churches everywhere were praying. People were calling, they were texting. And it just really touches your heart when you see the goodness of you. There's still so many people.
Try to deceive you, but the anointing which you have received from him abides. concerning all things, say all things.
All things.
And it's true. Come on, say it's true.
True.
And it's not a lie. And just as it has taught you, you will abide in him. And now, little children, abide in him, that when he appears, we may have confidence and not be ashamed before him at his coming. And if you know that he is righteous, you know that everyone who practices righteousness is born of him. How many know he's coming again?
Yeah.
We just want to be ready when he comes. We're going to stand before him, and we know that we have his righteousness, and we want that confidence not to be ashamed when he comes. How many know he's coming again?
Yeah.
He's coming again. We're living in an age we've never been before. Our country has been a place that's never been before. But God is the same.
Yeah.
Are you here?
Yeah.
God is the same. Chapter 24, I want to try to get over here, verse 3, and they're asking him about the second coming. I want you to know there's a difference in the rapture and the second coming, the second advent. The rapture is when Jesus comes through the clouds, and we that are alive, we're caught up together to meet him with those that have died before us. But the second coming is when he actually sets his foot on the Mount of Olives. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
And I mean, you're not going to have to worry about any kind of ropes. You're not going to have to worry about any kind of courts, because he is the King of Kings, right? And on that second coming, you're not going to have to fret and just worry if you got your way or not. I want you to know victory happened 2,000 years ago at the cross. That's where victory is. So the disciples were asking him, and they're kind of like people are right now, what in the world is going on? And he said, now as he said in verse 3, chapter 24 of Matthew, now as he said on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately, saying, tell us, when will these things be, and what will be the sign of your coming and the end of the age? Tell us what's about to happen. Jesus answered and said to them, take heed that no one deceives you. First thing, no one deceives you. No one deceives you. That's what I want to talk about. Don't be deceived. He said, let no one deceive you, for many will come in my name. And we saw that happen throughout, you know, the last, especially the last few hundred years or whatever. They're saying, I am the Christ, and will deceive many. He said, they will deceive many. I want you to get that. I don't want to be a part of that deception. Do you?
No.
I want to keep my focus on him, right?
Wow.
I'm not so much as interested in what people says as what this word says.
Wow.
Are you here? Because everybody's got an opinion about the Word of God. I mean, when I was in the mines, and you know, you'd be at different places, everybody's got their opinion. I believe this. Well, it really don't matter as much as what you believe. It's what God says. And it's believing what he says. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me today? It's going to be many to see. Verse 5, he said, for many will come in my name, and I have to say, I am the Christ, and will deceive many, and you will hear wars, rumors of war, see that you are not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines, pestilences, earthquakes in various places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Then they will deliver you up to tribulation, kill you, you'll be hated by all nations for my name's sake, and then many will be offended, listen to it, will betray one another, will hate one another, then many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. Now here's what I believe. I believe that we're not going to go through tribulation. Are you hearing me? I believe God is going to rapture us out of tribulation. What you need to be concerned with is be ready when that day comes. Are you hearing me? Let me read this. Now, brother, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, it's actually 1 through 12. I might not read it all, but listen, Paul saying, brethren, concerning the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and our gathering together to him, we ask you not to soon be shaken in mind or troubled, either by spirit or by word or by labor. As if from us, as though the day of Christ had come, they thought, you know, maybe it already came and they missed it. He says, let no one deceive you by any means, for that day will not come unless the falling away comes first, and the man of sin is revealed, the son of perdition, who opposes and exalts himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he sits as God in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God. still with you. I told you these things. And now you know what is restrained, that he may be revealed in his own time. Listen, for the mystery of lawlessness is already at work. How many can say amen? Amen. Only he who now restrains will do so until he, capital H, is taken out of the way. And then the lawless one will be revealed, whom the Lord will consume with the breath of his mouth and destroy with the brightness of his coming. Are you hearing me? The coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan with all power, signs, lying wonders, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish, because they did not receive the love of the truth that they might be saved. For this reason, say this reason, God will send this strong delusion that they should believe the lie, that they all may be condemned who did not believe the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. Not until that is moved out of the way. What I believe it is, and what according to what they and other scholars believe, that the church, when the church is moved out of the way, then the lawless one is going to be revealed. I believe that's getting ready to happen. I mean, we know things are getting bad, but when the Christians are getting better, we can get excited to realize that his word is being fulfilled. He said, don't be troubled. Don't be shaken in mind or troubled by spirit, by word, by letter. Somebody wants to tell you to create fear in your life. I want you to know God has it all in control.
Yeah.
And the enemy wants to raise up and say, this is going to happen.
Yeah.
What are you going to do when this happens? But you know what we're going to do? We're going to stand for truth regardless of what happens.
Oh.
Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life.
Yeah.
That's it. There ain't any others. There's not other God to look to. There's not any other way. It's only through him. Can I get it? Sorrows. Many are going to be offended. Many false prophets will rise and deceive many. It's in the Word. That's why we need to read the Bible. David Preachy teaches it every Thursday. We need to read the Bible. Do not go to what Grandpa said. Not go to what Uncle so-and-so said. Not because I heard of him. My uncle's read the Bible from Kevin to Kevin. Does he know the author of the Bible? It don't matter. It's important to read the Bible, but you can read the Bible and still be as lost as you can be. And you can understand that there's stories in there, and there's history, and there's good reading in there. But just reading the Bible is not going to change your life. It's not going to save you. You've got to be born again. Are you hearing me? People can tell all kinds of things. Well, the Lord knows this. The Lord knows that. And the Bible really don't mean that. I want you to know this morning, the Bible means exactly what the Bible says. We can't just interpret it the way that we want to and say, well, this is the way that it really is. Can I tell you that God understands where we are right now? So let's trust the word of the Lord. Now we know deception just don't, there's somebody behind deception. I mean, you can say amen. There's a spirit behind deception. The Bible calls him Satan in Revelation 12, 9. That serpent of old who is called the devil and Satan who deceives the whole world. How many know there's a lot of people deceived today? I mean, they think they can live any way they want to, and it don't make any difference. And if you try to tell them, you're just as guilty as them. Now listen, I got enough sense to know that I'm not in heaven yet. That I still have dealing with the flesh. There's still temptation. There's still trial. There's still tribulation. There's still trouble. I don't have everything together, and everything ain't perfect. Nobody is. But that don't mean we have a license to go out and do everything that we think of and want to do, and it's okay. It also don't mean that. It gives us a license to be free from sin. Paul said, should we continue in sin so we have more grace? He said, God forbid it. And I don't believe this thing. And listen, I'm not perfect. I know that. And there's a lot of things that have happened in my life and things that have happened in every one of our lives. But there's a difference in just walking in sin and thinking it's okay. Are you hearing me? Sin has to be repented of. It's just automatically not forgiven.
Yeah.
me to be free from sin. Not let's just go ahead and wallow around in it. God has so much more better than that. Are you here? I hope that you're here. I hope I'm not saying this too much. But it's time that we realize there's a difference in a Christian born again, has communion with God, than just somebody that knows a little bit about religion. The devil knows about religion. Are you hearing me? He's the deceiver. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 11:13, for such are false prophets, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into apostles of Christ. And no wonder, for Satan himself transformed himself into an angel of light. That's deception. I mean, how did they come up with these calls? Right? Some Mayan moon. Charlie Manson. I don't know if you even got that call. But how do you control people's mind and get them to do what you want? It's deception. Are you hearing me? How did somebody shut themselves up in a room in Waco, Texas? And they're the only ones right, and everybody else is wrong because they're believing the lie. And God says that. He turns us over to believe whatever we want to believe. How many want to believe truth today?
Yeah.
And I want to believe the truth. I'm telling you. Amen? Amen. This day and time, people just want to say, well, it's okay for that. I remember when I got saved, there's so many guys in a rock band. And I'm not saying that would send you to hell, but I'll just say some of them guys have seen a different preacher. Don't you think? No, it's okay for Mike to just continue playing music. Some of them would say, well, yeah, there's nothing wrong with that. And they say, man, I talked to this pastor. He said, he felt like it's okay. I said, you don't know, there's something happened inside of me that I don't want to do that anymore. It's not a thing that I can do it. I don't want to do it anymore. I'm like, did you get that in your head? It's not what I can get by with. It's what I can do for the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
Amen. And the devil wants to trick us, and he wants to change God's word. Chapter 3, Genesis. Now the serpent was more cunning than any other beast of the field which the Lord God had made. And he said to the woman, say for a father, that woman, he separated the woman and the man. And here's what the devil says. Has God indeed said you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? He didn't deny that there wasn't a God. He just said, did God really say what you think he said? I want you to hear this. And do you think God really would care about that one little bit? Are you hearing this voice? And the woman said to the serpent, we may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden. She left out one part that God said in chapter 2 about that. I want you to know she already left out some of the word. We can eat the fruit of the tree of the garden, but the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. Now first she's took away from the word, and she's added from the word. I want to tell you this morning, we can't take away from God's word. We can't add to God's word. We got to take him out of his word. The deception is the devil come in and said, but yeah, God spoke to you, but now does he really mean that? Is he such a loving God? Could he actually, you know, you go to hell for doing something like that? I want you to know if it's sin, it's sin.
Yeah.
And it ain't so much about others. I'm not going to battle that person. It don't have anything to do with doing it bad or doing it good. It's about following after God and loving him and obeying his word. Can't touch it or you're dying. Then the serpent said to the woman, well, you won't surely die. You know that ain't really going to happen. God loves you. And he is love. There's enough truth in there to confuse people. How else could it be deception? Right? If there's not enough truth to confuse you, it wouldn't be deception. If the devil come at you and told you to, you know, walk out from a coal truck, you'd probably have enough sense to say, I don't believe that's the Lord. But he'll tell you something that you think, man, that don't sound all that bad. Well, how could that really matter? It really matters because just a couple of three words here make a big difference. Are you hearing? Oh, God knows. He said, he didn't say you surely die, for God knows. Come on, say it. Here's the devil saying, God knows that saved. Look in verse 2. The woman said to the serpent, we may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden. But look, if you look over in chapter 2, let me try to find it here. In verse 16, the Lord God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may freely eat. Listen to it, freely. He wants to take away, the devil does, the grace. You try to earn it. How many people do you know that are living in bondage today? Because they feel like, I have to earn God's approval. I have to do it just like this, or I can't make it at all. How many people do you know of? I've got to quit doing this, quit doing that. I've got to try to live this way. There's a difference in the way we live, but it's not because after church I'm going to put on a t-shirt most likely. It's not about trying to live up to something. It's about his free grace that he gives freely. He can freely give. How many know you can come to God freely?
Yeah.
How many knows it's free?
Yeah.
It's not cheap, but it's free.
Yeah.
I can't earn my way into the kingdom of God. I mean, I can quit eating ice cream and drinking coke. That's not going to make me any older, make me thinner. Hallelujah. But that's not going to make me any more cleaner before God. How many know it's a free gift?
Amen.
I mean, there's so many people living in bondage because they got the bark on their ears. Lord, I mean, she started crying. Me and the pool boy, come on. Raven Casey's one called, and she's a bad influence. I'm sure. She's like her mom, she gets her ears pierced, and she's like 40 years old because it was wrong. She starts crying, and I thought, Lord, do you feel like you sinned? No, I feel free, she said. How many knows her freedom in God that is free? We can eat it all the, you know, except that one, but she didn't say you can freely eat. Are you hearing me? And listen to the one part in verse 3 in chapter 3. But the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat it, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. God didn't say you could touch it. She added that. Do we need to go back here and look at chapter 2? I can find it. But the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat. That's all it said. For in the day, she says, look at that, man, lest you die. But God says, you shall surely die. There's a big difference in you might die and you will die. I mean, no, there's a difference. She said, well, you might die. You can't touch this. If you eat it, die. God said, you eat of it, you will die. See, she changed the word of God. The devil knows the word of God. He was the worship leader. We heard David preach on him. He knows about God. He knows the word of God. So he wants to deceive you, to make you religious, and to believe just enough of the Bible to be deceived. Why do you know this morning that there's a true word of God?
Right.
It sets us free. We don't have to be in the bondage of sin. We're in the world. We're not of the world. We are going to make mistakes. Look at us.
Yes.
We're going to do things. We're going to upset people. I'm going to make Barbara mad. She's going to make me mad. But how many knows everything's good as far as with God if we obey Him and we say what He says?
Amen.
We don't take away from it. We don't add to it. We don't just believe that God thinks this is okay. We trust Him. We got to know the Word of God as what He said. We can't dispute it. We can't change it. We can't displace it. We can't make it say what we want it to say. How many times have we heard somebody do that? Here's what I believe. I don't believe that the Lord really, you know, went into the heart of the earth. Well, who cares what you believe? That's what I want to say. What I'm going to say to them, I'm going to read what the Bible says about it, right? Then it ain't going to matter what you think. false Jesuses. We're not going to stand before them, but we are going to stand before Him, right? There is going to be a white throne judgment, and we're going to stand before God. Big judge. The chief justice. The big chief, for you.
Yourself.
He wants you to know Him personally. I mean, throughout say, I believe you can handle everything that's happening right now. I think you can handle ISIS. Honest, God, do it. They may wear masks, but he knows what's under the mask. Yes. He knows who they are because he made them. Yes. But we're not, and it's hard for you to feel that rage or that, you know what, but we're not going to hate anybody. Jesus said, oh, love your enemy. Didn't he? Yes. And if your neighbor treats you bad, bake him a cake and take it over there. Don't put holes in it. But trust God and believe him. And listen, we can't be an example if we go running off everything's going on, and we know it's not what God's will is. We still can't be an example until we pray God in the middle of it. Are you hearing me? Go ahead and pray God. The devil just wants confusion, deception, where everybody's just sitting around, and I just don't know. I don't feel well. I just ain't getting anything. We just open the Bible, spend time in His Word. Barb can tell you, I don't read the Bible all day long, but I read the Bible. And I read it a little bit every day. I don't read 42 books and 20 chapters and try to keep up. I kind of got over that. But we have so much going on today, there's no excuse not to read the Bible. We don't have an excuse in the United States, in this country, to not read the Bible. And I want you to know this word is going to stand when everything else falls apart. Not one jot or tittle of his law will pass away till all these things be fulfilled. I want you to know that they're being fulfilled right in front of us.
Yeah.
So don't be afraid. Don't be dismayed. Trust God. Judges 21:25. In those days, there was no king in Israel. Everyone did what was right in his own eyes. And that's what the world wants to do right now. But whatever. There's a good popular song that came on when I was a kid. I want you to know, that's not according to the Bible. We have a king, right? We have somebody in control. We have somebody that's ruling and reigning, and you know where you are this morning. But listen, let's not twist the Word of God. Let's not take somebody else's word for what the Word of God said. Read it for yourself and have a relationship with God, and you're going to produce something. Something's going to come out of your life. Amen?
Amen.
Come on, let's stand and give Him praise.
Come on, give it praise.
Here I am, Lord. I repent for the things.